Hey everyone, how's it going? Adam or EposVox here, back with another Elgato Stream Deck tutorial. In this video, I'm going to finally show you guys what you've kind of been asking for, and that I'm going to show you how the Elgato Stream Deck can work greatly with OBS Studio. This is going to be pretty cool. I've already got both programs pulled up here with my main Twitch scene collection and profile, and if you want to learn more on how to set up OBS Studio properly, I have plenty of tutorials up on my channel, and I have a full new tutorial course for 2017 coming out very shortly. So in the Elgato Stream Deck, I actually have a dedicated button here for OBS, and now this is a folder. So if I tap on it on the actual keypad, you can see all the different scenes that I typically switch between with OBS Studio. So the Elgato Stream Deck has a few different features built into it for OBS, because they've worked directly with OBS to make a plugin that installs when you install the Stream Deck software. Now, you do have to have OBS open and on the proper profile and scene collection in order to customize it properly. We're going to make a new folder here, so we're going to drag a scene and a mixer audio, and I'll explain what this does in just a minute. I just want to make the folder first here. That's how you make a folder, by the way. If you miss my other tutorials, you drag two icons on top of each other and you make a folder. So you have three different types of selections here from the Stream Deck that you can choose from. You have a mixer audio source, and here down here you have the title. You can overlay some text. Hello. You can actually hit, which I did not know until recently, you can hit enter and keep typing on multiple lines, which is handy. But you also have this button to customize what level the text is at, the top, the center, or the bottom. By default, it's at the bottom. Alternatively, you could be setting up your own custom icons and not use the text, which we'll touch on in a moment. So then you have your scene collections, which are Twitch, and then you have a specific source. So for mixer audio, you're basically muting out your microphone with this, which is really cool. So if I select my mic aux right here, mic aux, which is my main microphone, you can see that over here on my OBS layer, it's picking up, you know, my microphone talking right now. So we have an on and an off, and it automatically darkens the icon that you have when things are turned off and has it brighter when they're turned on. So if we bring in a custom icon for this by double clicking the icon itself, and then I don't actually have, since I'm not using that specific thing at the moment, I don't have a specific icon for it, but we will just use, for example, starting soon. That's on, and then off is a little bit darker, and that's reflected on the actual keypad itself. So that is, we'll just call this microphone for now. So then if I touch the button on the keypad, you can see it gets darker here, and you can see in OBS, it muted out my microphone. So that's a real handy push to mute button, where you can toggle and mute your microphones. And you can do this for multiple audio sources. You can do this for mic one, mic two, capture card audio. You can mute out just about anything with that mixer audio source. Really freaking handy. It's also a relatively new feature to the software. The second one is switching between scenes, which is what I primarily use up here in my OBS layout. So these are all scenes. So collection and then a specific scene. Now, I went ahead and made an icon so I see that big green circle so I know exactly which one it's on without, you know, having to rely too much on the brightness. But you can see I've got starting soon, BRB, and you can see the little green circle changing as OBS itself changes. Offline, gameplay face cam, webcam, main, side, cam, chat. And all that does is switches between the scenes in OBS using the default transition you have here. Now, what's cool is you can actually enable studio mode and then still use these. And what this does is it just switches the right side using, again, the top transition here. So if I change this to fade and change this back to cut, now if I change scenes, it's going to... Actually, it's still using the default one. So if I change it to fade, yeah. So no matter what, it uses this default transition and time down here, regardless of what you're doing in studio mode. And that may seem a little obnoxious, but it's actually kind of nice because then you can still make tinkering within the studio mode here. You can still, you know, tinker with your settings and things like that, but switch scenes. Like, it's pretty neat. So the other type is an actual source switcher, which is what these meme overlay things are. So if I press the surprise one, I don't actually have a scene selected for that. Lol. All right, yeah, so there we go. Surprise, motherfucker. So that is the source toggle that you see here. So then you choose your scene collection, which again is my Twitch profile. The scene itself, which in this case is my overlays. I have a nested scene of my overlays. And then you have the actual source that you're toggling. which in this case it lists all the sources available in the scene. So if I go over here and click on the overlays scene in my Twitch or in my OBS, here we go, we got overlays. It lists all of these different sources and you choose which one you want to toggle. And it's really useful. This is how everyone's doing their memes with it. So then I click surprise, it turns it on. Once it plays there, surprise, turns it off. Pretty straightforward. And like I said, this is my example of what I use to create a very dynamic stream in which I can switch between a bunch of different camera angles, gameplay, PC, console, sponsored slides, everything all at once without having to do any crazy keyboard thing. I don't have to touch the mouse. I just reach over and tap this, and it's really neat. So we can run through what setup my actual OBS overlay is here. We can walk through the scenes that I have set up real quick. Now these three at the bottom are actually meme overlays that I picked up from Steggy at the Elgato team that I haven't made icons for, but that I've been testing out. And I don't know if they show over top of my slides here for you to see it. It does not look like that works. Okay. But so let's tour what I have going on at the moment. So I have starting soon, which is what you're seeing now. The hey, stream's about to start. I've got a BRB slide, which also these are image slideshows, but it navigates these specific scenes. And so be right back, and then it slides through some sponsored slides. And then the same thing for, hey, the stream is offline. Now move down here, we have a scene for my gameplay face cam, but specifically my PlayStation 4 gameplay face cam, because I stream some PC stuff as well as my console stuff. So I have a couple different, you know, actual physical scenes in my actual setup set up. And if you want to see more about my streaming setup, I do have a full office tour linked in the description down below. So if I tap on that scene, then you see over here, hello, I have a camcorder set up here above my monitor for my PS4. Then I have a dedicated button for my actual webcam itself mounted on my main webcam mounted on my monitor. Hello, that's what you see here. I have my main computer desktop, which is going to create an infinite loop. So don't freak out here for a minute. Bam. Got, you know, what you're seeing now as well as a webcam view. This is what I use in my editing tutorials. I have a side monitor view with my right hand monitor here, and this is usually a webcam for that. I like to have a webcam here. I'll just go ahead and point it up here so if I turn over and look at this monitor, I can still chat with the chat. I added pointed down because I was actually doing a Quake Live thing where I wanted a mouse cam going. Cam 3 is my camcorder full screen here, back over there. And then I have a special setup with the Twitch chat going that's kind of a little jacked right now. I'm actually going to switch that out for my Quake Live chat soon. And then I have a button that enables or disables certain overlays on the chat, which is pretty handy. So actually, if we pull up our console gameplay face cam, if I disable the overlays, it takes away the tip jar, and that's pretty much it. Originally, I had some bars at the bottom that had like top donator, recent tipper, all that jazz. But now it takes away my, since I'm an affiliate, I have a bitch jar. So that's a tour of what I have along with the memes, which are just video files. Green screened out here, and then that one is a full screen one picked up from Steggy's meme subreddit. I'll have it linked in the description down below. Now this one's actually just a normal hotkey. It's for a zoom in tool, which I use for some of my editing live streams. I don't even know if this will work with NVIDIA Shadowplay, so you may be seeing nothing right now, but it's a button that zooms in on the desktop a little bit. It's pretty cool. This was a bit of a longer tutorial, but this is hopefully showing you what you can do with the Elgato Stream Deck within OBS. I think you can do a lot with it, and I think it is pretty cool. So I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was, smash the like button, get subscribed for more awesome tech videos, and I will catch you